And now we will learn how to add transactions from the QBO review list in to our QuickBooks financial records. Right now, all the numbers in the QBO account that I am using are zero. I have not recorded any transactions in the financial records. We've only downloaded a review list from the bank. If we come back here, we can see these are the transactions that we have to review from the Chase business account before we put them in to the financial records. Now, in order to prove to you that this is an empty account, I'm going to open my custom-made trial balance so you can see this report does not contain any data. This is a trial balance showing the results of all dates, all transactions, all dates, and there's nothing here because the file is completely empty. But after we record our first transaction, we will see the numbers show up here once in the debit column and once in the credit column. For example, let's add the July 11th $200 deposit as video income earned from Alan Arby. Well, if we earn $200 in video income, that means video income will show up in the trial balance for $200. And if it was recorded from the Chase business account, the Chase business account will also show up here for the first time as $200. We click banking. We go back to the review list. And this first transaction was the one I was talking about a moment ago. It's in QuickBooks as a quick pay from a customer, but the income is not categorized and the customer is not defined. But QuickBooks saved us time by pulling it from the bank, so we don't have to record the whole thing ourselves. Click once on the line to open the blue bar below so that we can clarify. Now, the name of the account of the income that we earned in this case was, let's see, where are the income accounts? Here they are, and video weddings income. So that's what we earned, video weddings income. Now we'll choose the proper customer, in this case, Alan Arby. So now we have the customer, and we have the account it goes with, and now we're able to click Add. Now, once you click Add, you can see it disappears from the top of the review list. It's gone. It's not in the review list anymore. Where is it? If you click the In QuickBooks section, you can see all of the transactions that have been added to QuickBooks from the review list. Now, in order to prove this has affected our financial records, I'm going to click Reports. I'm going to open the trial balance again. And you can see we now have $200 recorded in the Chase business account and $200 recorded as income from wedding videos. Let's try one more. Let's add the $45 that we spent from the account on July 5th as delivery expense from UPS. So we go back to the banking center. And you can see the top of the review list has this $45 transaction that's really delivery expense for UPS. Click once anywhere in the line to bring the blue bar. Click Add because we're adding the transaction. The account, as we mentioned, was an expense. In this case, it was delivery expense. And the vendor who gave us that delivery is UPS. So now that we've clarified the transaction and that those are the only two things we have to put, we click Add, and we know it's been added to our QuickBooks records. We could click the In QuickBooks section to see every transaction that has been added to QuickBooks from the review list, or we could click Reports. And when we take a look at our trial balance, we see now we have delivery expense $45, wedding video income $200, and the difference is recorded in the Chase business account. You could also go back to banking, go back to the In QuickBooks review list, and double-click on the transaction to see what it would look like if you entered it manually, and you could add further details or edit this. For example, if we go in QuickBooks, this was added from the review list, but maybe we need to add more. Maybe to this one, we need, maybe to the one on July 5th, we need to add which customer or job. That's something you can add from the bank center. So we click on it. And now it looks like the regular expense window where you would normally record the transactions, and you could add, clarify, or change anything you want after it's added into QuickBooks.